took it out of the frame and I saw that I actually paid €7 for a postcard. Not even €3. I mean, it is just insane. Sometimes you have to do scary things to achieve something beautiful. What would you do with something like this? I know that you guys are expecting a blue and white farmhouse bedroom makeover video right now. By the time you see this video, I will be there. But right now, I am still in Amsterdam. I still have 3 more days. And there are a few things that I want to share. And a few little projects that I would love to do. I spent the last few days with organizing all of the art that I want to hang above the little table that I have in my living room. And I would really love to finish this little project before I go. And maybe do some decorating over there in this corner. It is very empty right now. But first, today there's something else. I want to show you all of the things that I bought at the very big antique vintage shop that we went to last week. After that, we went to a flea market. There are a few little things that I found at this flea market. But first, let's go take a look at some footage that I made yesterday. Yesterday was one of those days. I had this horrible, horrible morning and I decided I needed a break. I decided to go out of the north, into the west, to show you guys around a little bit in the west of Amsterdam. I went to a thrift store or two. I went to a beautiful, amazing park. I think it is about 90 hectares of greenery, which is amazing when you live in a city, right? I needed some fresh air, I needed some sunshine, I needed some exercise on my bike. I also filmed the big river at night. I love this river that we have in Amsterdam, and at night it is the most beautiful thing. So let's go take a look at the footage I made yesterday. After that I will be back and I am going to show you all the things that I found for my home, all the thrifted second-hand beauties that I found for my home.
I woke up this morning, I opened my eyes, and the first thing I thought was, oh no, it is going to be one of those days. I tried making myself a smoothie, the entire bottom of my blender fell apart. Smoothie all over my kitchen. And this was not the only thing that went wrong this morning. I thought, if my day is going south, I am going west. I need to go over there. Fresh air, sunshine, nature, a thrift store or two. But first I decided to go to the center of Amsterdam because there is nothing better on a day like this than to buy yourself a beautiful new dress. We'll be right back. That's beautiful. Look at this. All kinds of different compartments. Carpenter's chest. I'm on my way to an industrial area, to the second thrift store. I did not find anything I liked in the first one, except for the beautiful carpenter's chest, but it was very expensive. Look at the sky, so beautiful. The sun is almost going to set, but I still have 1 hour to snoop around in the second thrift store. This is beautiful. $150. Ah, I think I need a basket. I need a basket. I need a basket on wheels. Cute little vintage looking vest. Hey, this is actually a real sheepskin. €2.95. Wow.
Well, I really hope you enjoyed watching this little clip. Let me know if you would like to see more of Amsterdam, if you would like me to show you around a little bit more all over Amsterdam, because I really enjoy going out and filming all kinds of random things. One of the things that I love so much is that the street cleaners still use these old-fashioned brooms made out of branches. And also the river, especially by night, is just one of my favorite things. It is very peaceful in some strange kind of way. Anyway, what do you guys think of my new dress? It's amazing, isn't it? It is also very chilly. But one of the things that I bought, this very cute vintage vest that I bought for €4. And I think this is such a lovely, lovely combination. I was specifically looking for something to wear on top of this dress, and I am so happy that I found it. It is so nice and cozy and warm. When it gets really, really cold, of course, I have my amazing, amazing sheepskin. Not even €3. I mean, it is just insane. Normally these things are so expensive, and it is beautiful. It has no stains whatsoever. It is from an Icelandic sheep. I think this is an amazing find for my new bedroom. It will definitely go on top of my bed. It's a little bit sad that this cute little sheep is not alive anymore. I have to say, sometimes I have problems with thinking about things like that, but it is here now and it's mine.
Do we need a cute little kitten break? He is sleeping in these plates that I still have to hang on my wall somewhere all of the time. It is so cute. Are you sleepy, little? Who are you? I think this is Dim Sum.
Sometimes it's very hard to keep those two little kittens apart because they look alike so much. Of course, I did buy this beautiful little plate. I actually have quite a big collection of all kinds of blue and white plates and cups and teapots and all kinds of things for my kitchen. I just love this little blue and white plate. Let's jump back to summer vibes just for a second with this beautiful tablecloth that I found. I think this is absolutely perfect for the garden at the farmhouse. And I also think it is the perfect fit for the little garden table that we have. Can you imagine this tablecloth in the summer, sun is shining, view over the meadows and the water, big face of dahlias on top of the table. Very happy, very lovely, very beautiful. Great, great find. And how much did I pay for it? $2.50. I love this little teacup. Probably I will never use it, but I guess I can just put it somewhere and then I can look at it and I can think, I'm so happy that this is mine. Anyway, I did pay €5 for it. Not the cheapest little teacup. This whole shop was not the cheapest shop, but I do think that it is very, very beautiful. We just all need little cute teacups in our lives, right? And then we have this very vintage bag. I am turning into a vintage bag collector. I don't know what is going on, but I just loved it so much and I bought it. I actually do have a plan for these vintage bags that I am buying. I have a plan for it in my new bedroom. I'm not going to tell you what it is yet, but I have a plan. I will probably never use it as a handbag because I think handbags are so awkward. Just walking around with something in your hand all of the time is very unpractical, I think. But lovely, lovely bag. This is a little painting that I bought, and I actually bought it because of the beautiful dark moody fall colors. I feel a desperate need for fall colors at the moment. A beautiful little painting, even though it is quite moody. I don't know why, but I do like moody art. I do think that this is going to end up in my living room because I think it is nice to combine all the blue that I have over here with some really nice warm colors. And I don't know, I just think it is beautiful. I paid €4 for it. The vintage bag that I just showed you and this painting I found at the flea market. Another little thing that I also found at this flea market, something that I actually got for free, believe it or not. Little, what is it? A bust? Do you call this a bust? It is a little hat of a little girl, I think. And I bought this, where is it? Where is it? Where is it? Oh yes, it is over here. I bought this little drawing. It is a landscape. It has cows in it. And when I bought this, the lady that was selling this little drawing gave this to me for free. This will go on the wall above my little table in combination with all kinds of other things. I am going to change the frame though, because I want all of the frames around the art that is going to hang above this table to be white or creamy or bright at least. And this frame is definitely not bright. It is very boring, it is very brown. I think it is a little bit depressing and I think this is going to look much better. So this is still a little project that I need to do, change all of this out. I'm planning to do this tomorrow. I really hope that I can finish all of these things that I want to do. Another little piece of art that I found. This looks like something that came straight out of Lord of the Rings, I think. She has such a beautiful little face. Can you see this? She has very big ears. The man who sold this to me, he told me that this is a real Jan Torop drawing. Jan Torop was a very well-known Dutch artist. And his work is worth quite a lot of money. I paid €7 for this. I did not buy this because I thought it was worth a lot of money. I just bought it because I thought it was beautiful. With this little drawing, I already changed the frame that it was in. And then I discovered, when I took this out of the old frame, that it is actually a postcard. I have no idea if the guy that was selling this to me knew it was just a postcard. Maybe he really thought it was a real drawing, but I bought a postcard and I paid 7 euros for it. I still think that it is worth 7 euros, or at least to me it is, because it is very hard to find things that I really love to hang on my wall. And I actually really love this little drawing, so I'm happy. I'm happy, even though it is just a postcard. And maybe it is worth some money, because postcards sometimes can be worth a lot. I don't know, I don't care. I'm going to hang it on my wall and I'm going to love it. It is a funny little story though. I was laughing so hard when I took it out of the frame and I saw that I actually paid 7 euros for a postcard. Oh yes, this amazing, amazing lace. How do you call this in English? Bedspread, I guess. It is so beautiful. I don't know if it is the most suitable thing to put on my bed though, because you see everything that is underneath it. My plan was actually to make curtains out of it. So this is probably what I am going to use it for. I do think it is a little bit scary to get a pair of scissors and to cut into this amazing piece of lace, but I am probably going to be bold enough to do it. I think sometimes you have to do scary things to achieve something beautiful. What do you guys think of this? I think it is so beautiful. I paid 25 euros for it. Not a bad price actually for something like this. So another little addition for my new bedroom. I'm so excited about this new bedroom. I wish I could start this whole project today, but I can't. I have to practice my patience. There are a whole bunch of other things that I need to do first. Here is another little thing that I found for my living room. Beautiful little perfume bottle. I actually found this a couple of weeks ago, but this is the best time ever to show you all of the things that I've been gathering over the last few weeks, months, things that I haven't shown you yet. One of those things that I also bought a while ago is this. I have no idea what to do with it. I just bought it. I liked it. Maybe it will go underneath something. It is a very beautiful little piece of fabric with some lace around it and some blue embroidery. I just like it. I like it a lot. I just have no idea what I can do with it. I don't know what I'm going to do with it. What would you do with something like this? And then, ta-da-da-da, ta-da-da-da, this masterpiece of art. I bought this landscape. I cannot say that I am completely in love with it, but I do like it. And it fits in very well with all of the other things that I have for my new bedroom. I also bought this very elaborate gold frame for 10 euros at a flea market a while ago. I thought I would like the combination of this painting in this frame, and I do. I think it is a very nice fit, but it is not really the best fit for me though. I like this frame. I like this painting. All of these things together for me is just a little bit too, I don't know, too antique-y for my home. So I do think that I am going to see if I can find a different frame for this painting. And I think it would be nice to use this very big gold frame for a beautiful portrait of some sort. I just have to find myself a portrait of some sort. It was a nice experiment though to combine these two things. It is nice to figure out what you like and what you do not like, and I learned a little bit more about myself. And also now I know that I have to buy a portrait somewhere. I have to find myself a beautiful portrait for this beautiful frame, because I do actually really love this frame. So I think this was actually the last thing that I bought. I do not think that I have anything else. Thank you so much for watching this little video of mine. I really hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please let me know by giving it a thumbs up. Tomorrow I'm going to make a start with hanging all of my art on my wall. And after that, the blue and white farmhouse bedroom makeover it is. Really, it is. So, thank you so much for watching, and I really hope to see you very, very soon. Bye!